Welcome to Etcha. I'm Ben, your intrepid storyteller, and today I'm going to tell you the story of Half Hangit Maggie. Humans have been hanging humans in one way or another since the Roman Empire. And the most common method of hanging was the short drop, in which a person would drop merely an inch or two, their weight cinching the noose tight, strangling the person to death. It wasn't until a man by the name of William Marwood came along that we thought, maybe this isn't a good way to hang people. So we came up with the long drop. And the formula was this: 1260 feet per pound over the person's weight equals the length of the drop. This ensured that the neck would break at the second and third cervical vertebrae, or the fourth and fifth cervical vertebrae, thus ensuring a swift execution or a swift decapitation, which is why they changed it to 850 feet per pound force later. But fortunately and unfortunately for Maggie Dickson, the long drop method came a little too late. About 1.5 centuries too late. Margret Dickson was married to a sailor, and as sailors do, he went off to sea, leaving Margret Dickson alone by herself in the year of our Lord 1723. She then took up a position as a housekeeper in Edinburgh, Scotland, and she soon fell in love with the innkeeper's son, which, in lieu of modern birth control methods, got her pregnant. In Scotland at the time, it was a mite shameful to have fornicated, and it was even more shameful to have a child come of this fornication. Some accounts say that women who had children out of wedlock were forced to sit in a seat of shame every Sunday for many Sundays in front of everybody. For fear of the seat of shame, Maggie, who was about to pop, decided that the most sensible thing was to throw the baby in the river. But when she came to the edge of the water and looked down at the wee babe's face, she couldn't bring herself to go through with it. So she left the babe in the reeds, going off hoping that somebody would find the child. Unfortunately for her, someone did find the child a little too late. The child was dead. The local constable consulted Maggie's neighbors, who had seen her pregnancy quite obviously, even though Maggie thought she had gotten away with it. They then arrested Maggie, dragged her off to Grassmarket Square, and hung her until she stopped moving. Then a few of Maggie's acquaintances offered to load her into a cart and take her down to the grave. As it was in those days, and most any day, really, carting a body off to a grave is thirsty work, and there just happened to be a pub along the way. So Maggie's pallbearers decided to stop for a drink. After 1 or 2 pints, one of the men decided to go out for a smoke, and as he was lighting up his cigar, he saw the lid of the coffin move and freaked out. He ran back in and told the drunk pallbearers what he had seen. So they lifted the lid to Maggie's coffin and found her alive and, well as you can be after being hung in Grassmarket Square and surviving. Since Maggie had already been hung and many of the people in Edinburgh found Maggie's resurrection to be a sign from God that she had been pardoned, the government decided not to hang her, and she lived out the rest of her days being known as Half Hangit Maggie. The end. And now you must subscribe. Now is the part of the show where you subscribe, like, or comment down below. And thanks for listening to my stories.